This review on boosting the hormone GLP-1 by natural products concluded that there are compelling studies that suggest that the berberine in barberries, quercetin in capers, red onions, and buckwheat, ginseng, ginger root, gardenia, green tea, wheat fiber, soybeans, curcumin and turmeric, cinnamon, and resveratrol in grapes each have potent effects on GLP-1 activity. The hope is that increasing the release of our own GLP-1 hormone by eating specific foods could have similar benefits to GLP-1 mimicking drugs without the potentially disabling side effects. But anytime a review makes a statement of fact, like potent effects on GLP-1 activity, it's always important to dig up the original studies, the so-called primary literature. For example, here's the section on soy. Researchers demonstrated that soybeans can normalize blood sugars by inducing GLP-1 secretion, dietary consumption of soybean protein induces GLP-1, and moreover, soybean protein increases GLP-1 expression and secretion. This combined evidence strongly suggests that soybean protein exerts modulatory effects on GLP-1 secretion. Sounds great, but if you pull these three sources, that was based on studies on mice, rats, and in petri dishes. Gardenia-derived products also purportedly potentiate GLP-1 secretion based on cells and rodents, but when actually tested in humans, those in the gardenia group actually showed a decrease in GLP-1. Evidence also suggests ginseng improves GLP-1 secretion, but again, that's just evidence from rats and test tubes. What about that red wine compound resveratrol? Works in diabetic rats, but not in diabetic humans. Green tea is said to increase GLP-1 levels in actual patients, actual human patients. But in fact, the increase over placebo did not reach statistical significance. Olive oil is said to induce higher GLP-1 concentrations than butter, but the study that was cited, this one, actually showed no significant difference. This was on healthy subjects, though. A similar study on those with diabetes did show a larger GLP-1 response, though only by about 15%. Avocados have lots of monounsaturated fats too, and online you'll find so-called experts who claim that eating avocados can be as effective as getting weight loss injections, a food that works just like the miracle weight loss jab Ozempic. And that's from a nutritionist. Guacamozempic may work if you're a rat, but in humans, GLP-1 was found to be significantly lower in the avocado-added meal. Speaking of online speculation, what do we know about berberine, the supplement dubbed Nature's Ozempic, a component of barberries, a dried fruit I've previously profiled as a treatment for acne? Well, berberine boosts GLP-1 secretion in rats and petri dishes, but there haven't been any GLP-1 studies on humans yet. What we care about, though, is weight loss, and there have been a bunch of studies on the effects of berberine and barberries on body weight. No effect was found, either for berberine supplements or barberries themselves. This is all very disappointing. Something in the spice fenugreek seemed to boost GLP-1 signaling in a test tube, but there are no human studies. And it didn't even work in mice. So fenugreek flopped. But there are some spices that can legitimately boost GLP-1 in humans, which I'll cover next.